Hello friends, today we are going to learn dam break analysis using HECRAS. So let's start that. This is the HECRAS interface. Now I'll tell you what all data we will require for this, the input data. First we will require DEM of your study area, that is digital elevation model. Second is inflow flood hydrograph, and third is storage elevation curve. Okay, then let's start. First go to file, make a new project, select the location where you need to store your data. I will select F drive. Give a name to your project. I'll give 13 April breach. Okay, then go to options, change your unit, select to system, international metric system. Okay, then go to RAS mapper, here you have to go to tools and set your projection. I have just downloaded my projection, so I'm going to select from there. This projection file will be different for your study area, but what projection file I am using is universal projection file for all over India. So I'll give the description in your link. You can download it from there and put into your projection. Now change the unit into meters. Now apply. Okay, again go to tools. Now give your, now select new terrain. Now here you have to give your DEM, which I have told you earlier. Select your DEM, create. And just wait for some time. Okay, then after waiting for 28 seconds, this is complete. Okay, then now go to map layers, click it, right click it, go to add web imagery, select ArcGIS world imagery, select okay. Now this is our terrain. Again click, double click that, and decrease the resolution. Just right click it and go to image display properties and reduce the transparency little bit. Okay, now go to, now first you have to zoom your dam. My dam is Umrar dam, which is in Madhya Pradesh. I have taken that dam, which is a earthen dam. You can take any of them. So first I'll zoom to my dam. As you can see, this is my dam. Now we'll go to geometrics, right click it, now add geometry. I'll give a name, 13 April geometry. Okay, now automatically this all information will come, reverse cross section, storage area, 2D area. So you have to select 2D flow area, select it, double click it, go to perimeters, then right click, and now you have to give edit geometry. This is our dam. Okay, and this is our upstream area, and this is going to be our downstream area. This entire area is downstream area where flood will come and the area will inundate. So we have to make two areas. In perimeter we will make downstream area, and after that we will make storage areas. Okay, then now first we will make perimeter. I am marking first dam. Okay, this was the dam. Now from dam, the perimeter. can give this area from yourself. We'll mark the area. Now at last double click it. Now this is our perimeter one downstream area. Okay, as you can see, we have made our downstream area from dam. Now we are going to make our upstream area, which is in storage area. Click storage, right click it. Yeah, it has started. Again, you have to make storage area. Select the water portion area where the water is stored. Last double click it. Yes, this is now our storage area. Now go to file and save it, then exit RAS mapper. Yes, we have to save our file. Now go to view or edit geometric data, click it, go to file, open geometric data and select that data which we have saved, click OK. Yes, this is the area which we have saved. This is our downstream area and this is our storage area. We have to give, now we have to mention dam. So first right click it and zoom in this area. Yeah, now we have to give dam here. Go to this SA2D area,
click that,
make a dam. Again select that. Double click it, give a name, dam. Okay, then right click it, go to full plot. Now you have to give your outlet. From here you go to 2D area boundary condition line, give your outlet. This will be your outlet. Double click it, give the name, outlet. Now go to 2D flow area on the left side, go to generate computation points or regular interval, click it and give this cell size. I am giving 50:50. Generate 2D point area. Now click to force mesh recomputation. Wait for some time. You'll be creating mesh over here. Yeah, our mesh is created. So we got outlet, we got perimeter, we got dam and we got storage area. Now go to storage area. Yes, this is the storage elevation curve which the HackRAS has given you. It has generated self. So we also got the data from the dam authority. So we'll give our data into it and we'll put into it. I have already saved it. So this is the storage elevation curve. I'll select it. Copy. Select this area. Now paste it. Make sure your data should be in, volume should be in 1000 m³. Okay, my volume is in 1,000,000 m³, so I'm going to make it in 1000 m³. I have given the data, Just go to plot volume elevation. Yes, it should be in increasing order. If you have some data, then you can interpolate and give your data accordingly. So here we have to give some minimum elevation. Our minimum elevation is 476, so I'll give 477. Okay, now put press OK. Now go to 2D area connection, click here, go to wear embankment. You have to give your wear width. I'm giving 5 meter. Go to station, give your value 0, and elevation, select elevation from this. I'll select 486. This value will be the, this value 1592.10, 1592.10. Here elevation will be same, 486. Press OK. Now go to breach plan data. First select breach this structure. Go to, now we have to give your center station according to this graph. I will give my center station at 450. You have to give some final bottom width. I am giving 60 meter. Then final bottom elevation will be according to this. I will give 477. Okay. Give some slope. I am going to give 2:2. Breach formation time 1 hour. I'll give starting water surface elevation, which we have given earlier, 486 meter. Okay. We'll select OK. Then we have to cross this. The data has been saved. Now cross this geometric data editor. You have to go to this view editor, unsteady flow data. Here select this boundary condition. Now go to normal depth. Give some normal depth. I'm giving 0.01. Now you have to select add 2D flow area, add storage area. Right click. Sorry, click it, just click it. Okay. Yes, here one option is coming. Just click that area. Now you have to give your lateral inflow hydrograph, which you will be getting from dam authority. Yes, click into that and give some fixed time. Select this box, give some date, give your starting time. I am giving 00 hour. So you have to select the data from MS Excel, which you have saved earlier. Yes, this is my data. This is the inflow hydrograph data. I have copied it. I'm going to paste here. Yes, now you can see. Yes, you can see this is the flow versus time. So we got up to 20 hours, 1st September 20 hours data. So we have 20 hours data. You have to remember this data because we are going to use this data further. Okay, then press OK. Now you have to go to initial condition. Click here. Give initial elevation for storage area. As we have given earlier, 486. Give the same data. Click apply data. Now cross it. Now we have given every data what the software requires. Now we are going to run the software. You can see, we have to click here, perform an unsteady flow simulation. Click here. First we have to give short ID. I'm giving 01. Select this all data, geometric processor, this one also, sediment processor, floodplain mapping. Again you have to give some starting date. I'm going to give 1st September 00 hours. Ending date will be according to your data which you have given earlier. As I have said, we are having 20 hours data, so I'm going to give 19, one less than hour from 20. This is computational interval and mapping output interval. You have to give according to your data. So I'm going to give 5 seconds and mapping output interval as 30 seconds. Yes, we are going to compute it. Just see. Our breach has been started. Now we have to wait for some time. Wait for some more time. If you will have any error, it will automatically show here. Yes, we have some error, so we can change our computational time interval. We'll close it. Mapping output interval, we'll change it to 1 minute, and let's see again. Yes, as we can see, it has started running. The software is running. So now we have to wait for 10 to 15 minutes, and after that we can get our result. So I will pause the video, and once this is complete, I'll again start it. Okay friends, as we can see, it took 14 minutes 44 seconds to run this. Now close it. Go to RaskMapper. Yes. Go to full plot. Okay, now click to results. Double click it. First, we will see the depth. Yes, dam has broken, and you can see the inundation area. Now it will start from starting how dam break occurs. We can similarly, as we got depth, similarly we can see velocity and water surface elevation. Okay then, this was our result. So now every video will show you up to this only, but I'll show you further more, like how to extract this result from HackRas to ArcGIS, and from ArcGIS to your JPEG format. Okay then, we'll see it. First, click to depth, right click into it, go to edit map parameters, click maximum and click here, raster based on terrain, save map. Okay then, go to tools, click manage result map, click the depth, and go to compute or update stored maps. As you can see, this is processed. Okay, close it. Again, right click it. Now you have to again compute update stored map. Yes, this has been completed, and we have saved a file. Okay, let us check where this file has been saved. I have saved in my F drive, so let us check that. As we can see, my file is saved here in my F drive. First, I will copy it to I'll copy this to my desktop. Okay, now now open your ArcGIS. Now add data. We'll open that data. Yes, this is our data which we have saved there. Just wait for some time. Yes, we got the data. This is our data. This is the dam and this is the downstream area. So we can change the simulogy from here. Change the color. Can change the labeling also. I'll give 5 intervals. Generate it. Click OK. Apply. Then OK. Yes. Now you can give the legend also. First we'll go to layout view. Yes. We got the layout view. Now we'll click to insert. We'll add legend. Click next. You can change the font and size. I will give Times New Roman and I will give the size 22. Select next. Again next. Finish it. Your legend is building here. Yes, as you can see, we have got the legend here. You can adjust according to your own requirement. Now we can give insert north arrow also. North. Okay. Okay, so we gave this. And from here, once we made into ArcGIS, we can extract it into JPG format. Go to file, go to export map. Okay, then I'm going to save into my desktop. Yes, as we can see, the photo has been saved. Once again, I'll show you it. Go to file, go to export map. Give the location where you need to save. I will save in desktop. Make sure this should be in JPG format. See here. Yes, we can see we got into image format, and now you can copy it to wherever you want, into your thesis, into Word format, into presentation or anything. Okay friends, then this is all. We have completed our lecture. Thank you.